It's not a question just for students who are sitting here from the English department. It is for everybody. आज अगर यहाँ पे science, commerce field के students होते तो I would have said the same thing. The first thing that you need to check inside you when you have opted for a career is to see whether you're passionate about it. Because it might seem like a very theoretical thing. Passion, हर book में लिखा है you need to be passionate, you need to be extremely happy when you work. But I'm telling you, practical life में passionate होना बहुत ज़रूरी है. I'll tell you the reason. Some years back I heard a very famous line and that line said that you marry your career. जब मैंने वो line पहली बार सुनी थी, so I was amazed because actually it's very true. See, when we marry a life partner, we tend to be very cautious about our decision because उस इंसान के साथ हम अपनी ज़िंदगी के सबसे important time बिताएंगे. The same thing lies when you choose a career. Because एक career ऐसा चीज़ है जिसमें आप अपने life partner से ज़्यादा समय उस चीज़ के साथ बिताते हैं. आज जब मैं सुबह उठती हूँ तो द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट आई डू इज़ आई गो टू माई ऑफिस एट 9 एंड आई कम बैक एट 7. सो फ्रॉम 9 टू 7 आई एम विथ लिटरेचर, आई एम विथ स्टूडेंट्स कनेक्टेड टू लिटरेचर, आई एम टीचिंग देम. एंड अगर यहाँ पे मेरा पैशन नहीं होता, आई वुड हैव नॉट लव्ड माई जॉब, आई वुड हैव नॉट फेल्ट लाइक वेकिंग अप एवरी मॉर्निंग एंड टीचिंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ पैशन. प्लीज करियर तभी बनाइएगा उस चीज को इफ यू आर पैशनेट अबाउट इट. दिस इज अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल सेइंग विच आई लव. चूज अ करियर, चूज अ वर्क दैट यू लव एंड यू विल नेवर हैव टू वर्क अ डे इन योर लाइफ. इट विल ऑल अपियर टू बी अ प्ले. ओके, यू विल फील लाइक यू आर गोइंग देयर टू इंजॉय लाइफ. सो मेक श्योर करियर तभी बनाए वेन यू आर पैशनेट अबाउट इट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन यू मस्ट बी हैविंग इन योर हेड इज दैट कैसे पता चले वेदर वी आर पैशनेट अबाउट इट. सो द बेस्ट थिंग इज टू ट्राई. See, how many of you have seen that movie Dear Zindagi? Okay, a lot of you. So I can give you an example from that movie. Ek scene hota hai us movie mein where Alia Bhatt questions Shah Rukh Khan, who is the psychologist, that mujhe sab log bolte hain that I experiment with boys. Okay, I date a lot of boys and I feel as if I'm a slut. Okay, and Shah Rukh Khan, being a psychologist, says that, see, have you ever gone to shop for a chair? She says, yes, I have. So शाहरुख खान बोलता है कि क्या आप जाते ही पहली चेयर जो आपको शॉप पे दिखती है आप ले लेते हो. She says, no, we try to look at different chairs and then try to feel which one is the best. So that is when शाहरुख खान says that some chairs might appear good, some might feel comfortable but they look shitty. But finally you land upon that one chair which is perfect for you. So the same thing is with career. Try reading different books, different genres, and try to see if that book engages your attention. If that book is telling you to be with that, like this, that particular writer. Because literature is beautiful. When you read books, you'll fall in love with those writers, with those books, with those lines, and altogether you'll fall in love with lines. If you're not falling in love, that means you're not in love with literature. You are in a wrong path. You need to explore some other options. Yeah.
Well, along with literature, we also have relationship advice. Remember the chair analogy? I basically have this question on my own. What's your favorite book?
Okay, that's a very difficult one because when I was preparing for NET, I came across a lot of books which became my favorite. And I think my current favorite is Jane Eyre by Charlotte Bronte because I don't know, I feel so connected with Jane Eyre and her journey, and I think that every girl should read it because the sense of independence that book is going to give, no one else can do that.
Okay. Well, you know, like all of them have chosen English Honours, Department of English, but not all of them are avid readers. For I remember when I am a student here, when I came for my interview, ma'am asked me what sort of books do you read, and I was like Harry Potter. So what would be your advice on that?
Okay. Okay, two things I would like to tell you at this point. The first one is that try to start with a book or a genre you love. See, if you start with a book, like I am not a feminist, okay, and if I wanted to develop my love for reading and someone would have advised me to read a feminist work, I would have hated books altogether. So what I did was I started with the genre I love. So first thing, make sure every day, raat ko 30 minutes nikalo, take up a book, roz raat mein 30 minute padhne ki koshish karo. 4-5 days you might find that it's becoming boring. You might find as if the WhatsApp conversation you were having with your friend was more interesting than the book. But give that book a try, and after 5 days, I'm pretty sure if you are a book lover, if you are into literature and you are passionate about it, that book is going to be beside your bed trying to tell you that pick up and read the next chapter. So the first advice is start with a genre you love. And the second one, we all love movies, right? I don't know what's about movies, but then we all love movies in general. So start with adaptations of book. I remember when I was preparing for NET, there was this work by Ernest Hemingway, Farewell to Arms, okay, which I did not like when I read it first. Like, so then I thought that, okay, it's an important work, I have to read it for NET. So what I did was that I watched the movie, and after watching that movie, I fell in love with that book. And then I took that book again and I read it. And for that time, like the second time when I was reading it, I actually loved it. So if you're not so much into book reading, you can start with the adaptation, watch a movie, and then switch to the book. That will develop that love for literature in you, because you know exactly what the author is trying to say in the book, and you'll feel connected to it. So I think these two things.
So true. Well, you see, Harry Potter is not a bad book then. I'm a reader. How did you find the environment of Xavier's for the blooming of a literary mindset?
I think very enriching. This institute, I'm telling it from the core of my heart, not because I'm sitting here and I have to praise it. No, I'm just telling this because I actually feel it. And if you like visit my home someday and you ask my mom, she's going to agree with what I'm saying, because I've told her like several times. Xavier's give you a platform which is full of wisdom, as well as it gives you freedom. See, when a child is nurturing, it is very important that the child gets the freedom he deserves. If you keep a child in an overprotective environment, you will never let that child bloom. You will hamper the growth of the child. And the best thing about Xavier's is that here you'll get freedom to work the way you want, to study the way you want. Teachers are extremely cooperative. They're going to change the setup of the class so that you can get into the feel of the writer. I still remember Ritu ma'am was teaching us some romantic writers, and it was August month, and she took us into that open terrace. She asked us to sit there and just feel the poetry while the rain is pouring down. So that is how literature needs to be felt. So the college provides you excellent environment. It's a holistic learning experience. But then, just like with any new iPhone that is launched in the market, you need to be aware of the features. See, if I give iPhone to a 70 years old man, he might say that I just know how to call and how to message. That's it. So this college is like iPhone. It has so many features, so many faculties, so many options available, but you need to be aware what are the features you are looking for, and the college is ready to provide you that.
Wonderful. Ma'am, how do you think that literature has impacted you in all domains of life other than professional?
I think literature for the first time impacted me in all the other domains except the professional domain, because I took literature as a profession 1 year back. Before that, I was just a student, and the first thing that literature is going to teach you is to understand people. Like, I was just having a word with principal ma'am, and we were discussing the same thing, that literature students are better than psychologists. I'll tell you, if you have psychology as the optional subject, sit in the psychology class and just see what the teachers are talking about, and you'll exactly find the same thing in your books, in your novels, in your plays you're reading, because literature will give you a plethora of characters you can relate to. I have a friend of mine who looks, feels, behaves exactly like Daisy from Great Gatsby, okay? And when I read literature, like before that, I used to really feel bad about things she used to say, just because she was a friend of mine, I never told her anything. But then, after reading Great Gatsby, I exactly knew how she was, why she was behaving the way she was behaving. What happened in her childhood which made her feel like this? And then you start understanding, you start having a connection with students, with people. Also, literature will help you to understand yourself. I was a person who always used to see life as black and white, okay? For me, my moral codes were very strong. Ye hona chahiye, ye nahi hona chahiye. Aisa karna chahiye, aisa nahi karna chahiye. Subah jaldi uthna chahiye. All those motherly things were there in my head. When I started reading T.S. Eliot, Virginia Woolf, D.H. Lawrence, I was amazed. Oh my God, life is not in black or in white. It is somewhere in the middle of that, in the gray. And you can't always be yourself. There are times when you'll commit mistakes. There are times when you'll have emotions you'll never expect to have inside you. Because we all have human tendencies inside us. Kai baar hume ek choti si baat pe gussa aata hai aur hum apne aap ko bahut criticize karte hai. Ek failure se haar jate hai. When you look at these writers, their journeys, like ma'am was telling, sir was telling, John Milton, look at that writer, man. Without having eyes, he achieved something which we can never do. So you feel good about life, you feel passionate about it. Literature is going to take your spirituality to next level. Like, I was a very religious person since birth, but then I never understood spirituality, because if you look at Indian culture, it's like what has been depicted in OMG, okay? There is so much karam kandya that you can never understand what it means to have a real connection with God. When you read John Donne, when you read John Milton, when you read the essays of T.S. Eliot after he converted, you find that, okay, these guys are talking about what actual connection to God is. When you read these American transcendental writers, be it Emerson, be it Walt Whitman, you'll actually know, okay, you can have a connection with God in spite of the fact that you never visited a temple or you never visited a church. So that's what literature gives you. So it just, you just need to keep your eyes open, connect literature to life, and it will teach you something that no one else can teach you.